Hey, what up, everybody? This is Stephen Breach coming to you. Hope you guys are all getting ready for some Thursday night football action. It's going to be a great one. Of course, everybody knows you can check this out on CBS and the NFL Network. It's going to be the Minnesota Vikings going up against the Green Bay Packers. This one is always a great one. If I think back about this rivalry, I always think about, you know, Brett Favre. When he finally left the Packers and he made his way over to the Vikings after a horrible year with the New York Jets, he was able to, you know, rally up that team and really become a force in the NFL. You know, everybody knows that Favre's one goal once he left the Packers was to go and beat Green Bay just to show them that they made a mistake by telling him his career is over. But they had to go with the young gun, Aaron Rodgers. You know, Aaron Rodgers has come. And really made that team his own ever since he's taken it over. Everybody knows that Aaron Rodgers was able to bring a Super Bowl Lombardi trophy back to Green Bay, make that, you know, the victory championship park there. And they've been a great team for years. You know, everybody always circles the Packers on their calendar. The Vikings really have fallen off the face of the earth the last few years. They really haven't been able to put that great of a team together, really, since the team that really fell apart, that Favre was there, with the great wide receivers and the great defense. Just one thing led to another, and it sort of all crumbled apart. You can look at this as sort of a rivalry game, as Greg Jennings is going to be going up and playing against his former team. Everybody out there saw what Steve Smith did, basically, once he went back and finally played the Carolina Panthers. Steve Smith emerged as, you know, the Panther killing machine. So we'll have to see. You know, Jennings has put up some big numbers with 15 receptions and over 200 yards with one touchdown this season. Let's see if he can add on to that. When I think about this game, you know, both teams come in 2-2. And going into week 5, both of these teams have put up a lot of points. Both of these teams, their defense is subpar. That's probably the one thing that's really holding the Packers back from being a great team. Of course, they're coming off a win after beating the Bears last week, but also the Vikings are coming off a win after beating the Falcons in a shootout game last week. You can think that a lot of eyes will be on Teddy Bridgewater, the rookie coming out of Louisville. He took that job over. Last week, he got his ankle injured in the Atlanta game. Matt Castle has came out that said he is getting ready to play. But I think that if it comes down to it, I think Teddy Bridgewater is going to play in this game. He's going to show his toughness as being a pro. I know there's not a lot of recovery time from Sunday to Thursday. But I can see him getting out there and really throwing the ball around. And showing the nation, you know, there was a story that came out, you know, sort of redoing the NFL draft, even though they're only 4 weeks into the NFL season. And Teddy Bridgewater is one of the guys that sort of really fell from the Columbine, and he just didn't really have a good showing. And it really hurt him. He fell to, I believe, the last pick in the first round is when the Vikings took him. And, you know, he on this new list, you know, he's one of those, you know, premier players at the top of the list that really could be leading a team. I don't think that Bridgewater's thrown an interception in the league yet. I think he's sitting at about 400, maybe 500 yards passing. He hasn't thrown a touchdown, but he did run for a touchdown in the last game. So he has put points on the board. He has a good team behind him. Of course, we talked about Greg Jennings a minute ago, but I think a lot of talk about the Vikings was that they were just going to tank this year after Adrian Peterson got busted for the charges that are against him, and basically the NFL told them to sit him after the child abuse charges that were filed against him, you know, telling him to, you know, work out all of his legal stuff, and then there would be a spot for him on the roster once it was all said and done. He was able to come back. I remember watching the game, ended up being the game of the week on CBS. I can't remember who the Vikings were playing, but maybe it was the Patriot game. I think it was Vikings and Patriots. And I just remember, you know, sitting there thinking, man, the Vikings are going to get killed. They have no help here. And let's see what they're able to do. It was the only game that was on television here in Sacramento. But I fell in love with the running back of the Vikings, Matt Asita. I think that's how you say his name. I'm not 100% sure. I just love the way, you know, he runs the ball just right up the middle. I never really saw him break for an over a 10-yard run. But, you know, every time he did run the ball, he just ran with a force. And every time that he was in the backfield, I saw him protecting the pocket for Matt Castle, just making blocks left and right. I just fell in love with this guy. He's got the body of a fullback. But I think he's not going to be an all-pro. He's just one of those guys that you sort of point at and you say, that's going to be one of my favorite players. I love to watch him. He's not, got to go to the Pro Bowl. He's not going to be, you know, featured in the commercial. But that's the guy that I love to watch, and I'm going to watch him every chance that I get. He's having an almost better year than you can say on the other side. Eddie Lacy, who hasn't run for over 60 yards in a game yet. He does have one touchdown on the year, but he needed to really get it going. A lot of people really picked him in the first round of a lot of fantasy drafts, and they're really holding a fire under Lacy to hold up to, you know, the stats that he put up last year. And you look at the receiving core of the Green Bay Packers, you have a quarterback like Aaron Rodgers. Rodgers, who loves to chuck the ball around. You're always going to put up big stats. Jordy Nelson, almost 500 yards receiving with 3 touchdowns. Randall Cobb has found the end zone 5 times. This is a game that I think should have put up big points. The one thing that does scare me, this is a nighttime game at Green Bay, and it might rain. I think those conditions with the rain might make this not so much of a shootout, and it might be one on the ground. In that place, I'm thinking that I'm going to pick the Green Bay Packers to win this game. They're playing at home. It's going to be cold. It's going to be, windy and rainy. I think they're going to be able to handle the conditions better out there. And that's who I'm looking to win this Thursday night football game. Who you guys got? Packers or Vikings? I know that some people will be upset with me. I get lots of tweets about dogging the Vikings in my Pick'em League every week. And I want to respect the Vikings. I think that they'll hold up their own in this game. I'm just not 100% sure that they can do it. The Packers are a good team. They have a legacy built around them. And I think that as long as, you know, you got Clay Matthews out there, Aaron Rodgers, I think that leadership is going to be able to, you know, put points on the board. But Timmy Johnson out there, the 304, McLovin, much respect to you and your Vikings. I hope that you guys do pull out a victory, but I just don't think it's going to happen this Thursday. Peace out, everybody.